All right, now that we're playing a few chords, I want to talk about picks. So it's not 100% essential that you use a pick. Lots of guitarists don't use picks at all, especially as beginners. You may be more comfortable using your fingers, and that's fine. Use your fingers as long as you feel comfortable. However, even if it's not your favorite thing right now, you should at least try to experiment with a pick, with lots of different picks, to see if it's something that you might enjoy. The first thing that I want to say about picks is because they're so inexpensive and because they're so varied, it makes sense to get as many different picks as you can. I like to go not to like the big fancy guitar stores where they will only sell you 20 picks at a time of this certain kind. I like to go to like a little mom and pop guitar shop where the picks are usually unwrapped and in little drawers where you can pull them out and for a quarter each, you can take one of like 20 or 30 different kinds of picks. I like to do that, and at a quarter each, it's something you can do. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna show you my top four picks. So these are the picks that I like to use. I rotate with them sometimes, but generally speaking, these are my favorites. So number four is the Jim Dunlop Jazz III. So this is a small pick. If you hold this up to a regular size pick, you can see that there's a fairly substantial difference there, especially when you're talking about playing guitar. So this is the Jazz III, and what I like about this one is it's small and it's easy to grip, and that little point is super precise. This is a very precise pick. Because it's so precise, people who play in metal bands really like this. So John Petrucci, Kirk Hammett, a lot of others, this is like our super favorite. This is one of Dunlop's most popular picks, and these have been really popular since the mid-70s. So this is definitely a classic. Possibly not such a good beginner pick because you're not getting such good clearance from your knuckles to your point, but definitely one to keep in mind. Okay, number three favorite pick is the standard Jim Dunlop Nylon series. Okay, so I'm holding up two of them, and one is white and one is gray. Now, the way that it works is the lighter the pick, the thinner it is, and the darker it is, the thicker it is. So this is Dunlop's thinnest nylon pick at 0.46 millimeters. 0.46 is a very thin pick. This one is a mid-range at 0.73. And then the heaviest one is 1 millimeter in this series. They do make thicker ones, but not in the standard nylon. This, if I'm gonna say, well, what's your most basic kind of pick? I would say this is like your super standard pick. Nylon, so it's got some really good flexibility. The feedback isn't transmitted as much to your hand. So this is one of my favorites. And that's something you want to think about too when you're thinking about picks. When I was a beginner, I preferred a thinner pick. Even now, after 10 years, I still prefer a thinner pick. And the reason is because the thicker the pick is, the more vibration gets transmitted to your hand. And for me, I feel like it messes with my strumming. So I'm comfortable with a thicker pick, but not as much as I am with a thinner pick. When I was a beginner, I couldn't touch a thick pick at all. Another example of a thick pick is this is another Jim Dunlop. This is the big stubby. This is 3 millimeters. So this is huge as far as guitar pick standards go. So, I mean, I don't know how well we're able to see this, but this is 0.73, really thin. This is more than 3 times the thickness. So you will certainly feel this. You'll feel the vibration in your hand. But, you know, pick one up and try it and see what you think. Dunlop makes all kinds of ones. This one is called Ultex. That's just the material that it's made out of. So they make picks out of all kinds of different materials that have different characteristics, different grips, just to see what you like. Number two pick, we're staying with Dunlop. They've all been Dunlop so far. This is the Tortex is the material, but that's not the reason I like this one. It's because this is a sharp pick. So it has this point to it. And I really like the sound that this point makes. For some reason, to me, it sounds like it's much more precise than the more rounded nose picks. So this is one that I really like. This is my, like I said, my second one. This is like a go-to pick. So finally, my number one pick, which is very different from the other ones, this is the Fender 355 Triangle Medium Gauge. I love this pick, and I love it for a couple of reasons. Number one, its size makes it super easy to grip. This is not a two-finger pick. You can, but you can really get like 3-4 fingers on this thing, and it's not going to go anywhere. So I love that about it. The other thing, and this was especially true when I was a beginner, because of its size, there's so much clearance between the tip of this pick and where my knuckles are. So when I was first learning how to strum and I was not super precise, there was much less scraping my fingers on the guitar strings because this had so much out in front of it. And when I have this pick, I really can be, feel more free to attack the strings. So if there's one pick that I'm carrying around in my wallet with me, it's this one. So to sum up, get a bunch. Try as many as you want. You never know, something that seems totally not what you want may strike you, and there's no reason just not to try as many different ones as you can to find the one that you're most comfortable with. Thank you very much for watching. Please make sure to subscribe so you get the latest guitar lessons.